Hey guys, welcome to the next video on OpenCV tutorial for beginners using Python. In the last video, we have seen how we can install OpenCV for Python. Now from this video, we will actually start writing some code. Now moving forward, I will be using PyCharm IDE to demonstrate how OpenCV works, but you are free to use any IDE or any other editor in order to use OpenCV. Now on PyCharm IDE, you need to install OpenCV little bit differently. So if you are using OpenCV, you just need to create a project inside OpenCV, and then you just need to click on file and then go to the settings. Now once the settings window opens, you just need to go to the project, and then it'll say after colon your project name. So my project name is OpenCV examples. That's why it's written here OpenCV examples. So project colon your project name. So just click on this section and then click on project interpreter. And on the right hand side, you will see all the packages which comes pre-installed when you create a project inside PyCharm IDE. Now we want OpenCV Python package. So to install OpenCV Python package on PyCharm, you just need to click on this plus button here, and then you just need to type OpenCV-Python. Now the first result you can see here is OpenCV-Python, and the version which is available right now is 4.0.0.21, which is the latest version. So to install this package for your PyCharm IDE, you just need to click on install package button, and then after some time you will see this message which says package OpenCV-Python installed successfully in the green bar. That means OpenCV package is installed successfully. So you can close this window, and now you will be able to see OpenCV-Python is added to your packages, and also NumPy is added to your packages, which comes with your OpenCV Python package. So I'm going to just click OK, and now you will be able to import this CV2 package in your Python script. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how you can read images and write images using CV2 package. Now let me show you where you can find some sample images for your project. So you can open the browser and then go to this URL github.com/OpenCV. So just go to this URL, and then under this OpenCV project in GitHub, you will be able to see these repositories. You just need to choose this repository which says OpenCV, and then you can scroll down, and all the images you will find inside the samples folder. So I'm going to go inside the sample folder, and then inside the sample folder, you just need to go inside the data folder. So here you will find many sample images and videos and other files which you can use in your project for the learning purpose. So you can use these images in order to develop your example. So what I generally do is I just go to this repository which is under the URL github.com/OpenCV/OpenCV, and then I either download the zip file of this project or clone this GitHub repository on my operating system. And once you clone or download this repository, it'll look like this. So it will be downloaded as this folder, which is OpenCV-master. And once again, you can go to the samples folder here, and inside the samples folder, you can go to the data folder, and you will find all those images which I have shown you on the GitHub repository. Now to start with, we will be using this image, which is lena.jpg. So I'm going to just copy this image for now, and then I'm going to go to my PyCharm IDE, and then I'm going to just paste this image inside my project. So this JPG image will be directly available inside my project folder. Now let's see how we can read images using the CV2 module. So you just need to use CV2, and there is a method called imread which enables you to read the images. So the first argument which you need to give here is the image name. So I'm going to give the image name, which is lena.jpg, and the second argument here is a flag. So there are three flags you can give here. You can either give 0 or 1 or -1 flag here. So this second argument is a flag which specifies the way images should be read. So let me show you all the flags here. So the first flag is cv2.imread_color, or you can give the integer value of it, which is 1. And whenever you give this flag as the second argument of imread function, it's going to load the colored image. If you give this flag, which is cv2.imread_grayscale, or if you give this integer value, which is 0, it's going to load your image in grayscale mode. And the third flag is imread_unchanged, or the value -1, which is going to load your image as it is, including the alpha channel. So for now, we are going to just give here 0 flag, which means we want to load our image in grayscale. So now let's run the code and let's see what happens until this point. So you can see our code runs fine without giving any error. Now let me give any random name here as the file name and once again run this code. And once again, you will see that there is no exception which is thrown here. So even if you give the wrong file path or file name here, this function is not going to give you any error. Now, in case of wrong path or wrong file name, let's say I'm going to just assign this value to a new variable, which is img, and let's print the value of this img using the print method, and then let me run the code once again. And you can see whenever you will give the wrong file name here or wrong path here, as a result of this method, you will get none. So you can check the value of image, and if it is equal to none, then you know that you have done something wrong, or you have given some wrong file name or wrong path here. Let's give the correct file name. So I'm going to give the correct file name and then run the code once again. And now this time you will see it's going to give you a matrix, which means that it has read all the pixels from this image and then assigned it to our img variable, and the result you can see in the form of this matrix. So until now we have just read the image. Now we want to display our image. So in order to display our image, what we can do is we can use a cv2.imshow method. So just write imshow here, which is going to show your image. So the first argument here will be the name of your window in which your image will open. So you can give any name here. For example, I'm going to give image name here to my window. And then the second argument is the image variable, which you have read using the imread method. So I'm going to just pass img variable, which is this variable here. So now will it show the image? Let's check. So I'm going to run the code once again, and you can see the image is shown for a millisecond and then it disappears. So now we need to add something which will wait for the image to disappear. So I'm going to add one more method here, which is cv2.waitKey. So this cv2.waitKey is the keyboard binding function, and the argument which it takes is the number of milliseconds for which you want to show your image window. So let's give 5000 value here, which means we want to show the image for 5 seconds. And at last, what we are going to do is, after we have done seeing our image, we will destroy the window which we have created. So you can just give this method cv2 destroy all windows. So destroy all windows simply destroys all the windows which we have created. There is one more method, which is destroy window, and this method you can use to destroy a particular window, which we will see little bit later. But for now, we will just use this method, which says destroy all windows. So now let's run our code and let's see what happens. So now this time you can see our image is loaded for 5 seconds, and our image is loaded in grayscale mode. Now if you give here 0 as the argument of wait key method, then let's see what happens. So I'm going to run my code, and now you will observe that your window will not disappear after 5 seconds or any number of seconds. It's going to wait for the closing of this window, which we can close from this close button. And you can see it's loaded in the grayscale mode. I'm going to close this window, and here as an argument of I am read image, the second argument I want to give here right now is 1, which means the colored image. And let's run the code, and you can see this image is loaded in the colored mode now. Let's also check the -1 argument, which is unchanged. So it's going to just load the image as it is with alpha channels. So let me just close this image once again. So now we have understood how we can read an image using imread function. So let's see how we can write an image to a file using a function called imwrite. So we are going to just use cv2 once again, and then there is a method called imwrite, which you can use to write an image in the form of a file. So the first argument here will be the image name, whatever you want to give here. So here, let's say we want to give the name to our image as lena_copy.png. So the image will be saved as the file name lena_copy.png file. And the second argument which it takes is the image you want to save. So let's save the same image which we have read using the imread function inside this img variable and pass it as the second variable here. And let's run the code and let's see what happens. So our image is loaded using this imshow function. And now when I close this window here, you will observe one more file will be created here. So let me just close this window. And now you can see, as soon as I close this window, this method is called. And after this, this imwrite method will be called. And when this method is called, this image is created with the name lena_copy.png. We can also open this image, and you can see it has the same image which we have seen in the case of lena.jpg. So let me close these two images. So now we have understood how we can read the images and write the images using imread function and imwrite function. So let's make our code little bit better. And what we want to do here now is, let's say if somebody presses an escape key, then only we want to destroy all the windows without saving it into a new file. Otherwise, if somebody presses the S key, then we are going to save this file with the new name, let's say lena_copy.png file. So I'm going to just capture the output of my wait key. So just create a new variable, let's say k. So now when we press any key, this key will be captured in this variable. Now, as you know, every key has its own value. So we are going to just use a if condition, and we are going to just check whether the value of k is equal to 27, which means that we have pressed the escape key. And if somebody have pressed the escape key, we are going to simply destroy all the windows. Otherwise, let's give the second condition, which is L if k is equal to ORD, and this is a built-in function, and it takes one argument, which is the key name which we want to press. So let's say somebody presses the S key, and if somebody presses the S key, we just want to save the image which we have read using the imread function to a second image which we call lena_copy.png, and then we will simply destroy all the windows which we have created using imshow method. So let's run the code and let's see what happens. So I'm going to run the code. So this image is loaded, and as soon as I press escape button, you can see this image disappears. That means this condition is met and this method is called, and all the windows will be destroyed without saving the image. Let's delete this image and let's see what will happen when we press the save key. So let me just delete this image, and now let's run the code once again, and this time I'm going to press the S key. And once again, you can see the windows are destroyed, but this image is created once again using this function. That means this time this condition is fulfilled and this image is created, and after that all the windows are destroyed. So this code is working fine for me, but in the documentation it's also written that if you are using a 64-bit machine, it's better use this notation with your wait key method, which is wait key and this mask here, and then once again when we run our code it works as it is. But in case if it doesn't work, you can try using this mask here. So this is how you can read and write images using OpenCV. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next video.